You were so, the entire cast. But the role of Tevye has got to be so intimidating because it's been done so well and so prominently. How do you put your own spin on it? Which you did, by the way.
Thank you very much. I'm trying not to get scared from things that I'm doing.
Well, you're very noted. You have quite a big career, so I knew.
But it's true because I think, you know, there are so many big roles in theater, especially, that has been done so many times, you know, from Hamlet to King Lear to whatever, just name it. And look, I mean, you can just learn from these great people that, that did those roles. And just take it from there, you know, thinking every role that you're doing, you're attacking it from a place where you, what you has to bring to it, right? What you have to bring into it, and what is your own story into this character. And slowly, slowly, I find that it's so personally for me, you know, that it has nothing to do with the past or future. It has to do with my own story, with my grandmother and grandfather.
Is there a Tevye in your life?
There's like a whole Tevye story.
And that's what
in
I wanted to
life.
Ask you as well. This seems to hit so close to home for you, for your own interpretation. Is it like that for you, even on a nightly basis, as often as you perform this?
Sorry.
Hitting so close to home, making it so personal for you.
It's first of all, I'm here with my three daughters and my wife. So talking about it every day, you know, to my three daughters on stage, and coming back home, they're doing the tour with me. So
That's
this
awesome.
Tour is becoming really family thing, you know, like traveling with them makes it even closer to home, right? But slowly, slowly, you know. Realizing that that my grandparents coming from Russia, you know, they came to Israel through the desert, through the, you know, on donkeys and camels, and running away from the pogroms that they had there in Russia, and getting all this background, this history behind me, and you know, Tevye, the way it's written, so Jewish, so Israeli Jewish also, you know, has this ironic thing that, and the way you deal with tragedy, it's the way we deal with it. You know, I mean, you have to bring a little bit of humor in anything that happens to you.
That's a great
otherwise,
way to put it.
Otherwise,
really
there's no.
It's
used to live.
It's truly enjoyable. First of all, it's just a wonderful, my favorite musical ever. I mean, the music is just crazy. The choreography is amazing.
Yeah. Every song there is like.
Yes. But it's also really, we're in a moment right now in history where not just in America, but across the world, there's a rise in nationalism and more vocally. There seems to be a willingness for people to vocalize hatred. Is it really important to see Fiddler from that point of view?
I think so. I think, sure. I mean, unfortunately, Fiddler is stays relevant.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Unfortunately.
Right.
I mean, yeah. And now more than ever, I think, because there is a new wave of that we see that all over the world, I think Bart, the director, was really very much insist on bringing that on stage. The way we play, the thing that we're carrying with us, it's not only the love story, it's not only the you know, the Tevye with God, you know, it's not in that, it's all has to have something deeper in the story of the, it's not only anti-Semitic, you know, according to the Jewish community. It's a general thing that happens, that we bring it on stage. That's what keeps, I think, that, and he think, of course, and he always reminded us that.
And yet, within that hatred, there's also that one-on-one relationship, and showing that as people, we can be friends no matter what. So
it is an incredible production, and it's one that many people in Memphis should come out to see. We appreciate you being here.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We put the information on the screen. The Orpheum Theater is the place you can check out Fiddler on the Roof.